they took it. You know, because some stuff, I'm writing a lot of music, and I heard the voice of one of the guys. I was like, man, this would fit him better than me. So I gave him a couple ideas, you know.
I know you had told me that you had, I know from your travels that you do a lot international. I'm glad you brought that up, because I was going to ask you how your contacts, the people that you work with around the world, how they felt about it, how they may, you know, have done anything different or notable that you wanted to include or share with us.
They have people over there, the way that they perform and stuff. A lot of them were doing the same thing that everybody else was doing, benefiting from the viral shows. And some of them went on BBC when they were over in England. So
right,
that was really
yeah.
cool to watch. And, you know, so that's a good thing to get on if you're over there in England. And
John Bon Jovial, I see you're sitting by. You want to jump in here with something?
Well, you know, first of all, Cody, welcome. We're really glad that you're back with us again. But I want to rewind a little bit here and go to Out of Control, which, you know, I'm listening. I don't get to listen to the stuff beforehand because David wants, a visceral gut reaction, if you will, from me. And, you know, if it's a horrible song, I'm not going to say it's horrible. And in this case, thank goodness it's not. It's a great tune. The thing I like about it is that the combination of the bass and the lead guitar, are you playing everything or you actually have a band backing you?
I switch playing around. It's just two guys. It's myself and John Grant.
Okay, because first of all, who's ever playing the bass is just working their butt off, and I really like that.
Fingers too.
And the guitar has a distortion to it, which I love. And the first thing that I thought of was, you know, this is something where I'm going to sit around in my lounge chair in the driveway drinking a beer on a hot afternoon listening to this garage band play, because that's the impression that I get, that you guys are a garage band. And I say that in the nicest way possible as a compliment, because that's, you know, I love that kind of rock and roll. And I think you kill it. You just get right into it there.
Great. I'm glad you enjoyed it. I kind of saw, you know, it's kind of, if you listen to it, it's like a little bit of Angus Young, kind of a little bit like throwing that in there when he does that one lead going down.
Yeah.
That's what
yeah,
it kind
it
of
is.
Reminded me of a little bit. And I was like, yeah, I like Angus Young. So, yeah, let's leave it in there.
That'll work. And it does. You just prove that. Go ahead.
Where does this Out of Control? Where does this come from? What spawned this song?
Well, the area is on the YouTube channel for Creases of Clay for the area. It's an area called Fells Point in Baltimore and Maryland where I live. So it used to be that it's like a, you know, rocking town for, you know, for playing their music down there. You know, a lot of acoustic and music going on. And, you know, the Out of Control is basically, it's just a drinking song, you know, and just like you're losing it. It's like you might never come back, man. You're ready to party. So, and that's really what it's about. You know, it's partying off and just drinking, really. It's a drinking song.
I think we've all been there one time or another. Hey, I'm just curious.
Oh, yeah.
Were you at any point during the creation of this song, were you out of control?
I've been out of control my whole life.
Well, hey, listen, I respect your candor. Hey, but you're still going, you're still doing it, and you ain't locked up or dead, so you can't be doing all that badly. And, you know, I'm glad you mentioned Baltimore on the Maryland area, because you got hit pretty good with that storm, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. It wasn't good.
Yeah, I know the Mar-a-Lago, that's a whole other place. What do they call that? It's Maryland and Delaware. They've got a name for the two states combined. Del Marvel, that's the area. Right there on the Chesapeake Bay, bounded on the north by that horrible bridge, which I went over late one night.
I think in some respects, you guys up north, you got it a lot worse than we did down here in Florida. I'm on the Southwest Florida coast, and there was some wind and some rain, but I think that once it hit up in your neighborhood there, I don't think the storm was maybe physically as strong, but I think the consequences were a lot worse for your neck of the woods than they were down here.
Yeah, well, it hasn't been good. I mean, plus, to the rain all the time, it's been so hot for the past couple of weeks. And not, you know, up in the 90s and all that.
Oh, my gosh. That's cool for us. But yes, I was going to say, to answer your question, yes, I have been over that bridge in the dead of night.
Oh, God love you.
He must have, because I made it.
I'm scared of that bridge, but I'm scared now for some reason. I don't like going over it, so I go the long way through Delaware. I go over that bridge.
Yeah, saying scared is one way of putting it, but you know, I just respect it immensely. It's, you know, it's not a pleasure cruise where you kick back, put the top down, grab a cold one, and just cruise across and listening to music up loud. It's one that you have to you have to take seriously.
Well, the reason why I said scared is because I because it's Smaltimore. That's what we call Baltimore, because everybody knows somebody. And believe me, I know people that work on that thing, and they tell me that you don't want to go over it.
Well, I'm glad I'm not going to be doing it again right away.
You don't want to drive over it. I was like, okay, I think you're worth for it.
Yeah, I heard you. And the really sad part is, actually, I've been over it twice. Once way back when I was in the Army and stationed at Fort Belvoir, Virginia. I don't remember too much about that, but the most recent time was a mistake. I missed a turn that I didn't know I was supposed to make, and all of a sudden I'm on this bridge, and I'm saying, wait a minute, I'm not supposed to be on a bridge. What am I doing here? It felt like Mr. Custer, but hey, it's the breaks of the game. Cody, back to the music. Now, you've told us that you spent a lot of time writing during the pandemic, during the lockdown and everything. What have you come up with? Have you got some new stuff coming in the near future? Is it still in the creative stages, or where are you at with your new music?
I have a song called Angel Eyes coming out soon. Should be looking for that one. I'll be recording that one. I really don't tell too many people, but since I'm on your show, I'll tell you. I've been getting ready July 31st. I'm going to go into the studio. I got the phones already done, and it's in A, but it's a good song. I think this one, a lot of people will like this one, too.
Well, you'll be sure and get us a copy, and we'll definitely play it.
Oh, yeah, I definitely will. I'll make sure Veronica will give it to you, a copy, because it'll be coming out. I'm not going to I'm going to push Stone and Twine for a little while longer, and then I'm going to push this out.
Now that you mentioned it, while you think of her, while I think of her, you be sure and thank Veronica Forrest for all the work she does, both for you, tremendous support of you, and also working with, us strangers out in the media that play your music. She is wonderful to work with, very thorough, and she follows up on everything. I love the girl. She's a good lady. So be sure and give her our thanks from right here. You mentioned also, I love the way you do. You take this away from me. I don't have to have notes and think about what to say. One, you answer questions before I ask them, and two, you lead me on into my next question. And my next question is, you mentioned So Entwined, which just happens coincidentally to be the track we're going to close this segment with. Tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, what would you like to know?
Everything. Tell us first, where did the idea come from, the seed that became the finished plant?
Well, I'm a spiritual person, so I was kind of thinking about God and my relationship with him, back and forth kind of a thing, you know, and that's kind of how it ended up. And then I was thinking, well, everybody probably think it's all probably some beautiful woman or whatever, you know. And I was like, no, it's just my relationship back and forth. You know, good, you do bad. Do good, you do bad. So it's kind of one of those things.
So sounds like life.
And I was just kind of like, you know, thinking about the words and how would it be, you know, open up the window, you let the breeze in, you never overshadow. Basically, you got free will. It never overshadows. But I closed the window, you know, because it's my fault, really. And that's kind of where it comes in. And then just the seventh line kind of just rhymed and divine. And I was like, oh, that sounds good. So I threw that together. And
you're kind of,
you know, when I'm like, I try to put some emotion into it, try to make it like a love song, you know, and that's kind of how I was going for a love song. So that's really what I was trying to do. So I was thinking along those lines.
For something you just threw together, you appear to be quite a deep thinker, and I'm not sure exactly how I'm trying to say this, but you're a deep thinker, and you're able to take those thoughts and not just throw them up against the wall so everybody can see them, but to actually communicate them while you're in those thoughts. It's not like you get an idea and say, oh, well, let's see, and you think about it, and then you sit there and write it down and move on to the next thing you're going to do. It's like you're in those thoughts as you're creating the lyric.
Yeah, so along those lines, I would say, definitely, you know, to add on to that, you know, when I'm, it's like I was wanting to be emotional when I was in the studio too, so it seemed like it came out the way it should have, you know. I tried to do, you know, the best I could singing wise. Like, I practiced it a lot. This is like, I don't usually practice this that much before I go into the studio. I still practice, but not as much as I did on that one. I was like, I have to practice this one a lot.
Gotcha. Now, what's coming up in the immediate?
I'm sorry,
I didn't mean to interrupt you.
I was just trying to, like, say the emotional aspect of it.
Gotcha. Sorry to step on you there. What's coming up in the immediate future for you? You're going to do some play dates now? You're going out on tour? I know you said you're going in the studio the end of July. What else is going on?
Well, this weekend, a couple people are having some guests over. I guess it's like around 20 people. I'll be solo, I think, on this one. If there's any musicians there, hopefully there are. Maybe somebody can get up and we can, you know, do some cover songs and have some fun. So this weekend's just like hanging out with some friends and their friends coming over. They want me to play, and I was like, "Yeah, that's fine." They like my music, and they want me to come down. So I was like, "All right,
great,
sounds good
great.
To me."
Sounds good to me too. If I was down in the area, I think I'd crash the party and come on by. But unfortunately, I'm going to be about 2,500 miles away, and that's a long commute for the weekend. Before we let you go, Codie, tell the folks how they can find you online, where they can contact you, follow you, get your music, which is the important thing.
All right, well, creaturesofclaytheband.com, and all the links for Facebook and all the Spotify and wherever you want to listen, Apple, whatever, it's on my website at creaturesofclaytheband.com. You can also go into YouTube, Creatures of Clay. I'm also on there. And, of course, you know, Veronica, see, if you go to the website, creaturesofclaytheband.com, you can find Veronica on Twitter, the promoter there, and she's all over the place with it. And if you want any information, she's got it.
She is that. Great. Thank you so much for joining us, Codie. I almost called you Clay. Come on, Creature. Thanks for being here. We're glad to have you here. So glad to have you come back and see us again. And we will look forward to the next time. Also, look forward to that new release about the end of July, first part of August.
All right. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. Again, say hello to Veronica. Ladies and gentlemen, Creatures of Clay is the band. You've been listening to Codie Westwood, and now you're going to listen to the tune he was talking about last, So Entwined. Thank you.